So the last thing I want to talk about in terms of end-to-end experience design are three things: foundations, exploration, and application. So the first of these elements is called, is what I call foundations, and this is nothing new, but it's something we often overlook. As we think about the logical progress an individual will take along a learning journey, let's call it, it needs to begin with some kind of compelling evidence that they need to actually learn something different. It needs to start with some basic core information, frameworks, models, key concepts, and that sort of thing. And it needs to get them energized about some kind of structured learning that's going to happen thereafter. So the question here is, what do we do when we think about our content areas or our learning interventions that actually calls out what is foundational in nature and may drive us to think differently about the formats and modalities in which that foundational set of experience happens? Too often, what we find is that the entire learning process is jammed into a two-day event. Well, that's not only does it not work, because learning and application at work takes a lot longer, but it's also hugely inefficient. I, as an individual, can get very excited and learn a few basic things and data collect and all sorts of things in advance of what then becomes less of a program, more of a workshop. The second concept has to do with exploration, and I really like to think of it in those terms. It's not talking head, throwing things at you, obviously. It's more of a, we're all hands in, I'm with other people, I've got all the supplies necessary, and we're exploring these topics in a guided way with subject matter experts, peers, mentors, coaches, and others all around us to help us really deepen the learning around those content areas and do that in a structured and guided and helpful way. So that's exploration, and that, in my mind, that really translates to live events. So live events where you actually do have to have dialogue. You actually do have to have the input from other people around you. You want to engage with others, and that's what exploration is really all about. So now we're going from foundations to exploration, and we're not done, because what we often see also is a lack of support. Once I'm done with the exploration, how do I go back to work and do things differently? So the last element is around application. So these stages of learning being foundations, exploration, and application. Application is really what kind of guides, what kind of networks, what kind of tools do we enable our learners with so that when they get back to work, they can actually do what's different and new for them in a guided and supported way with the right tools, with the right content, with the right networks of people to support them. So if you start thinking about that and you add in this level of what's going to be surprising in each of those stages, and also how do you build the intentional dependencies across those stages, I think that gets us to what we call the end-to-end experience design.